Reveiw, Melanie Mills, Toasted Blonde. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to review Perfectly Pressed Powder by Limelight by Alcone. See you soon. Okay, we're in my office studio that's under construction. I've got some painting going on and things are changing. It's gonna be like a month till I get things straightened out here. So I was like, I'm just gonna keep filming. Background's weird. Sorry, deal with it. Or don't deal with it, turn it off. I don't have anything pretty to look at. So let's talk about Perfectly Pressed Powder, okay? It's by Limelight by Alcone. I've been using this for 6 months and I finally hit pan. I haven't been using it, you know, every day. I've been using some other stuff, but I've been using the hell out of this and it lasts me 6 months, so I'm pretty pleased with that. So let's go through the details. It's $22, you get 13 grams. Let me check my numbers. It's $22 in the US dollars, $30 in Canada, and you get 22 grams, okay? It's translucent powder. I think it has like 5 ingredients. Talc is the number one ingredient. And let's just take a quick break there, quick detour. I was hesitant about the ingredient talc, because I was like, oh, talcum powder, is that bad for you? Because like in baby powder and stuff, they didn't like it. But I researched it. Cosmetic grade talc is supposedly safe. It's not like 100% safe, but all the studies have shown that it doesn't contain asbestos, which was what the problem was way back when. So they say it's safe, and they do tests on, and this is made in America, so the FDA has done tests, like random tests on different products and different sources of talc in the US, and they've had showed no problems with the talc containing asbestos. Now, there are still, you know, like many things, they don't know if, you know, talc itself is carcinogenic, but there's like not really any concern about that, so it's safe. And I was worried, I didn't know if I was using something bad, but I wasn't, and which is good news. Okay, let's do another disclaimer. I don't sell Limelight by Alcone. I'm not a beauty guide. I'm not a makeup guru. I'm just me, Melanie Mills. I like to put on makeup. Okay, let's see. Oh, I bought this with my own money. My sister-in-law was selling Limelight, so I bought a whole shit ton of stuff, and now I'm giving reviews because I couldn't find any online when I first started shopping, so I wanted to share and get some actual, honest, real-person reviews, not people that sell the product. So that's why I'm doing this. And if you want the type of video, subscribe to my channel or watch some more of my videos. And thanks, I hope you enjoy it. Okay, let's get back to the video. I really like this powder because I have sensitive skin and rosacea. It does not itch, burn, sting. It doesn't make me more red. Now several other powders I have used have made me a little itchy. I'm looking at you, Laura Mercier, setting powder. I don't know why, but right here along my jawline, I get itchy when I use it. I really like the way that one works, but that's another review. But so this one, no itch, and I really, really appreciate that. I find that it helps the lasting power of my foundation, especially when I'm using Botanical Foundation by Limelight. And I find that it doesn't seem to give a cast or a glow in pictures or whatnot. Yeah. Okay, so I was looking for a dupe for this, something to compare it to. And the only dupe I can find online that has a similar ingredients would be Trish McAvoy. Her finishing powder, translucent finishing powder. The first 4 ingredients are exactly the same, and then hers has some additional. The last one isn't the same and some additional ingredients, but the first 4 are the same. So it's probably going to have a similar finish. The itchiness and irritants would be different because there's different ingredients, but it's similar to that one. All right, and then, so wrap it up. This is a fast video. It works. It works. Would I buy it again? Okay, this is the thing. If my sister-in-law was still selling Limelight and I ran out, then I would buy it again to support her, because I'm looking for something to support my family member. But would I go out of my way to buy this powder? I don't know. This is going to last probably a year's worth. I'll probably try another one, because that's what you do when you buy makeup. I don't always repurchase. But there's nothing wrong with it. There's like absolutely nothing wrong with this. And really what I should do is just rebuy this one, but I'm always looking for a cheaper, better, different option. And then the final thing I should say is I am no expert on this. I've used Laura Mercier finishing powder. I've used Mineral Veil finishing powder. Most of the time I use a dual matte powder by Makeup Forever, which is actually like foundation powder for finishing powder. So that's it. And then what else have I used? Some other random powders that are probably powder foundations. So I'm no expert on the like three that I've used, which is, you know, Laura Mercier, and both of those are all the famous ones. So I'd say I think I like this one the best because of the itchiness. I really did like the cast that the original Mineral Veil had it on it way back when I first tried it, but I actually had tried it recently and hadn't liked it as much as I did back then. So I don't know. It's a good product. If your friend's selling it and you want something to buy and you want to spend $22 and get a perfectly pressed powder and a cute little compact that lasts a long time, go for it. I'm Melanie Mills, Toasted Blonde. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel. Bye.